Our July 2008 tour of Virginia battlefields began with a stop at the Jackson Shrine in Guinea Station, Virginia. Jackson was moved here to be close to rail transportation following his being wounded by friendly fire at Chancellorsville in May of 1863. The shrine is now maintained by the National Park Service, which keeps an interpretive guide on location. Stonewall Jackson's arm had been amputated near Wilderness Tavern, and Jackson was expected to recover from his wounds. But by the time his wife arrived here to escort him home, he was already in the last stages of a deadly case of pneumonia. This building is now all that remains of the original plantation, which was acquired by the railroad and later given to the National Park Service. The house originally stood in this location, marked by the sign in the lower center of the photograph. It was here in this bed that Thomas J. Jackson finally awoke from his delirium and uttered his famous last words. "Let us cross over the river and rest under the shade of the trees." The clock on the mantelpiece is original to the time period and was here in the room when Jackson died. Other furnishings are authentic to the time period, but not to this building. After visiting the Jackson Shrine, we moved on to the Cold Harbor battlefield. It was here that General U.S. Grant attempted a futile effort to dislodge entrenched Confederates along a 5-mile front. Even today, 143 years after this battle, those entrenchments are still clearly visible. And they leave little doubt why, in less than half an hour, more than 7,000 Union soldiers were shot down while crossing the open field before them. Here, near the old Cold Harbor crossroads, Federal troops were expected to advance from this location to the tree line in the distance. When the assault failed, they dug their own trenches and remained here for several days before moving south to Petersburg. The clear evidence of these trenches after more than a century of erosion suggests how very defensible they must have been. This monument is dedicated to the 2nd Connecticut Heavy Artillery, who fought here as infantry and died in huge numbers while still wearing their brand new uniforms. Only days before the Cold Harbor battle, this heavy artillery unit had been guarding Washington, D.C., but Grant called them to reinforce his losses following the battles of the Wilderness and Spotsylvania. When it became evident that an attack on his entrenched enemy at Cold Harbor was futile, Grant moved his army south to Petersburg. But by the time he arrived there, the Confederate troops were once again dug in protecting the city of Petersburg, and so began a 292-day siege. Grant selected City Point as his supply depot, and within weeks, it became the busiest port in the world, supplying food, weapons, and clothing to Grant's troops, while the besieged Confederate forces grew hungrier and hungrier. Across the James River, the Depot Field Hospital became the largest and finest hospital in the Army. A modern hospital stands on the same location today and is visible just to the right of this photograph. Appomattox Plantation, owned by Dr. Epps, became the offices for the Quartermaster General of the Union Armies while they were at Petersburg. But Grant himself did not use it for personal lodging. Over the years, the Epps House remained in the hands of the Epps family before being converted into apartments. Today, it has been restored by the National Park Service and is open to the public. The house has seen many modifications over the years and offers an odd mix of both the old and the modern. President Abraham Lincoln arrived at City Point aboard the River Queen on March 27, 1865. Aboard the River Queen, Lincoln met with Generals Grant and Sherman and Admiral Porter to discuss how the war should be brought to its end. General Grant's headquarters cabin, a very simple log and frame structure, is today on display along the James River on the Epps property. In 1866, this cabin was shipped to Philadelphia's Fairmont Park, where it was put on display. After the Centennial Exhibition, however, it fell into disrepair and was nearly forgotten. Today, the cabin is largely a reconstruction, which uses both original lumber as well as new lumber as needed. The original door to the structure has been saved and is on display inside the Epps House. During the Siege of Petersburg, General Grant was sometimes visited by his wife, Julia. Today, the wharf at what was once the world's busiest port is represented by a park. It is difficult to imagine how this quiet place had once been filled with the sounds of dock workers, steamships, and locomotives. But the wide, deep channel of the James River and its close proximity to Grant's line made City Point the perfect supply depot.